Now let's pass the border between Italy and France.
So here I am at the border of France and Italy, and on this side we have France, and on this other side we have Italy. So we need to understand that this point is strategic for many, many things. And also about environment, because we changed the country, it means that we changed the rules and we changed the providers and everything. So this is why, you know, I think that we need to have a global vision of this river, and this border is a very big problem, you know, for environmental management. Here at the border, indeed, they wanted to show the cooperation between France and Italy, and it's about environment, so that's a good point. So we'll go and have a look at this sign and we'll find out. So they say that it's a project of community initiative, Interreg Alcotra, with many organizations actually, Alpi Latine Cooperazione Transfrontaliera, Fédération des Alpes-Maritimes, des associations agréées pour la pêche et la protection du milieu aquatique, so for fishing and the river protection, le Conseil Général des Alpes-Maritimes, so this is the organization, you know, for the French department, la Federazione Italiana di Pesca Sportiva Attività Subacquea, with the Federation in Italy for sport, fishing and water activities, the Ligurian region and the province of Imperia. And actually, the goal is to develop a sustainable tourism, which will be attractive and competitive on both sides of the border and while protecting the environment. So this is good because this is exactly what I want to do. So I guess that all these people will be motivated by the fact of helping me, France, Italy, European Community, and all these organizations. Yes, because we are at the border and we need to be very careful about environment and about the Roya River, which is just down there. So that's a very big challenge for future, and showing this at the border is a good idea, and we have to do more. So now let's visit the electricity power plants of France.
Now let's talk about the dam, which is situated in Le Ravin de la Masque. So it is the fourth infrastructure on the Roya River, the first on the French side. This plant is made to help actually the Roya River accelerate its flow. So we find different basins in which the water can go.
So here we are in Vienne, we are in France, and in Le Ravin de la Masque. And we have this dam that falls, and actually that accelerates the current that flows into the Roya. So here is the little dam, and then it flows this way. And see there with the stones, and naturally the current actually is accelerated into the Roya River. So that's very important actually to understand how naturally, you know, the water can flow, and I think that it eases the way actually of the water and avoids flooding and many issues. And here we have a little reservoir there. And here we have the van actually, and we see that the water was there not long ago. So this is a small system as well, and with this dam and this reservoir. And actually I see that there they stocked the wood just on the shore of the river. But this wood is not our wood, so we're fine. And I would like to attract your attention, you know, on the geology, you know, of this place. We're in the Alps and we have many curiosities, you know, and actually all this was made by water and wind and erosion and everything. And we need to understand that everything is related, geography, geology, water, everything. And just a little bit up north, we have the electricity plant. So I'll go and I will bring you there so we can see.
So now let's talk about the electricity power plant and reservoir, which is situated in Brive-sur-Roya. So this plant is just before the place where the water is accelerated by the different basins we just talked about. And we find a reservoir which is related to the electricity plant with tubes.
So here we are at the hydro plant, which is just behind the little dam, and we have all the installations, you know, of the electricity and the Roya River, which is here. And this is the equipment that they have. And do you hear the noise? It's very, very loud. And this hydropower plant is managed by EDF. And here as well, they created this little path, you know, for the water. And then it flows into the Roya River. And here we have the equipment, you know, for the electricity. So here indeed we see that to move the flow of the water, they needed to build big things, you know, in the past, and they still remain today, they're still used, you know.
Now let's talk about the lake and dam in Bray-sur-Roya. So the village of Bray-sur-Roya is about at the middle of the Roya River in the mountains, and we find two particularities. The first is a place with different basins to accelerate the water, and the second is a lake, which is indeed a reservoir.
So now I'm in Bray-sur-Roya, which is one of the cities actually of the National Park of the Mercantour. And we have a dam, and I will show you. So on this part we have the natural river, and on the other part we have the big dam, and we see that all the vans actually are opened and they fill the river Roya. So we see that in Bray-sur-Roya this is not a small dam, this is something big with a big flow of water as well. Today, as you can see, it's a sunny day, so we don't have much water, you know, that naturally flows. But we can already imagine what happens, you know, when you have those torrential rains. So that is to say that those dams, you know, maybe they contribute actually also to the regular flooding that we have. And also, I don't see any sign saying that we're in a zone of flooding or a sudden wave, or there is nothing at all. And as we can see, you know, the shore, they're quite eroded as well, due actually to this big amount of water that comes into the river. So I will go a little bit up north and I will show you the lake of retention that they have in Bray-sur-Roya. As you can see behind me, Bray-sur-Roya is one of the cities actually that was in the county of Nizza in the past, and actually it might be one of the reasons why this situation is this way today, because we need to know that this land once belonged to France, then to Italy, and to France. So we wonder actually what happened, and we actually have the result of the story, the end of the story. And the more I think it, the more I think that this region was left untouched after the Second World War. And maybe this is why we have so many issues here in the area. And this is why I want to reopen the file of this region, you know, and of the treaties as well, you know, between France and Italy, because regarding environment and sustainable development, we need to know that we have to see the things in a global way, and that's what I want to do regarding environment and regarding the management of this river. So I am now in the sweet village of Bray-sur-Roya, and I will show you the scenery because this is just lovely. So here is Bray-sur-Roya, the little village, and it's very quiet and peaceful. And here is the lake actually, which is a reservoir and for the dam. And we see that they use it actually for the territory, and we have a nice walk, and it's nature. This is really wonderful. And we wouldn't think that 100 meters behind me we have this big dam, you know, that accelerates the water. Here everything is so calm, and it changes a lot, you know, the river, you know, in a couple of meters. And That's amazing. That's also, you know, the magic of this place, you know. And that's very important. This river is very important for the territory.
Now I propose you to discover the electricity power plant and the two reservoirs which are situated in Saoj. There we are in the upper parts of the Roya River, and the electric power plant is made to provide electricity to the village of Saoj and its surroundings. So we have this electricity power plant, and we have this tube that goes from the plant until the two reservoirs that are situated above the plant.
So here we are in Saoj, still in France, and we have this plant there. And I can't go because it's on the other side of the river. But we see that they do electricity as well. So I will head north because there is still another plant that I would like to show you.
Now let's talk about the electricity power plant of Pagana and its lake situated in the village of Fontan. So we are in the upper part of the Roya River. We are very close to the zone of confluence, and we have a small water system with a plant, lake or reservoir just above the plant.
Here is the plant of Pagana on the French side, still on the Roya. Here we are in Fontan, and we see that we have another little dam and an electricity plant and the tube that goes in the mountain. And here we have a path actually for the water, you know, where they do. So here the yellow sign, it seems to inform us that it's dangerous, so we have it actually in the bed of the river. So I think actually that this big tube is related to this sort of tube which is hidden under, because we see that there the water flows. So it's a very big system, you know, of hydrography that they built years ago actually. Here we have also the little streams, you know, on the cascades, and they all fill actually this Roya River, which is just on the other side there. So before the dam, actually, we see that everything is calm, and then arrives the dam and the big falls on the water. And there we see the reservoir there. And we have very big boulders, you know, that fell from the mountains. So here is the big tube that brings the water into the power plant, actually. And if they put actually the reservoir above the plant, it's to accelerate the speed of the water because it helps to create electricity. And here we have the big equipment for the electricity and the draining of the water. So here on the French side of the Roya, the electricity is managed by EDF, whereas on the Italian side is managed by Tirreno Power. Having two big energy suppliers actually on the same territory is also one of the issues. So this is why I think we should manage it in a global way, especially due to the issues of sustainable development, because we need to know that for the Roya River there is no border.
Now let's talk about the biggest electricity power plant of the Roya River, which is situated in Saint-Dalmas. So it's a big system with an electricity power plant and with a tube that brings the water from above to the plant to transform actually the energy of the water into electricity.
So here I'm in the electricity power plant of Saint-Dalmas, which is actually the biggest, and that creates the whole electricity in the region. We need to know that this point is very strategic. So here is the real strategic place, you know, for the distribution of electricity indeed in the valley. So here actually they show the whole region, you know, and those big lakes there with the dams, four lakes, then again four lakes, then two dams, and the big lake of Les Mèches with this capacity. So we see it's quite big, huh? So we are in a very strategic place, and we have this little sign, an explanation that explains us actually the hydraulic production over there in the valley of the Roya. And here actually they tell us that we can have waves and risk of sudden flood, that we can't run in the bed of the river and everything. And we'll have a look actually at the river. So here it's very wild and no problem, because actually the thing is done in the mountains. We see there is the electricity equipment. So here in San Delmas, they tell us as well about the danger of sudden wave. We need to know that this place is strategic for the region. There was this group of people who were there, and they disagreed, with some of the decisions of the government, and they decided to slow the electricity during a while, because actually they know everything about the network and how to do the things. So that's a very big problem. And when I speak about security, this point enters as well in the field of security.